Welcome back to Logitech. In my last video, I show you the benchmark of RTX 3080 Ti. Well, I know that this GPU consumes high power, which is around 350 watt. However, there is a way to reduce the power usage of this GPU, which is you need to do undervolting. Well, in this video, I will show you how to undervolt this RTX 3080 Ti. Firstly, you need to install the MSI Afterburner. Make sure to install the latest MSI Afterburner beta version. After you install the MSI Afterburner, click this Wi-Fi signal icon and it will show up the curve of the GPU voltage and frequency. There is two ways to undervolt this GPU. First is, you don't clock the GPU all of the minimum clock. After that, you pick the voltage that you want to use or you want to set, and then you set up in certain amount of your frequency. After you click apply, it will directly convert all the graph to the frequency that you set before. However, this method have a drawback, which is if you use it at the low usage, which is below your frequency, the power consumption will be higher than the normal. So there is the second method, which is you need to drop the dot one by one. This method is taking so long. You need to drop one by one dot to match your set frequency and voltage. So I suggest you do this after you do the first step. Now let's try out my undervolting setting. I use Heaven benchmark to test out stability of my undervolting. Take a note that I test this in my computer, not my benchmarking device, so the temperature is higher than open air. The score will also a little bit lower than normal since I using Nvidia Shadowplay to record the video. Let's take a look at the stock setting. Temperature reach 80 degrees Celsius and max power draw is 350 watt. The chip only power draw is 187 watt, means 171 watt is for other component. The score is at 5332. Let's start the undervolting setting. Remember to reduce 15 more MHz from stable test to avoid crash in certain game, since it might jump 15 more MHz in certain game and cause crash. The first setting I use is 90% power limit with 0.875V and 1875 MHz. Temperature down to 76.5 Celsius and max power draw is 323 Watt. Chip only power draw reduced to 152 Watt, but the other components still the same. The score is at 5392. Next setting is active 5% power limit with 0.85V and 1845 MHz. Temperature down to 75 Celsius and max power draw is 303 Watt. Chip only power draw reduced to 137 Watt and other components likely reduced to 166 Watt. The score is at 5350. The last is 80% power limit with 0.825 Watt and 1785 MHz. I cannot get stable at 1800 MHz since when I set to 1800, frequency increased by 15 in some games and causing crash. Temperature down to 72 Celsius and max power draw is 280 Watt. Chip only power draw reduced to 122 Watt and other components likely reduce again to 150 watt. The score is at 50-77 and this is the lowest setting if you want to play nicely. Below this point, the performance reduced significant. Moving to the gaming performance. Since I already make video with ultra wide QHD with 3 comparison, I cannot trim it nicely, leaving blank space in 16:9 resolution. First, we have Shadow of Tomb Raider. 80% power limit is about 1.5% slower than stock, and 90% power limit is about 2.3% faster. However, the 1% low is higher at 80% power limit compared to the stock. The power draw reduced by about 80 watt in 80% and 40 watt in 90%. Next, we have Far Cry 5. 80% power limit is about the same with the stock, and 90% power limit is about 3% faster. However, 1% low is so low at 80% power limit. The power draw reduced by up to 100 watt in 80% and 60 watt in 90%. The last is Forza Horizon 4. 80% power limit is about 4% slower than stock, and 90% power limit is same as the stock. The power draw reduced by up to 110 watt in 80% and 80 watt in 90%. This is massive power saving. The rest of the game comparison you can see at my other channel, Loki Bench. From the gaming benchmark result, you can see that this card can perform up to 100 watt less power than the stock in the game. However, the drawback is in certain game, the FPS average will be reduced. I test below 80% power limit and the result is not good, because you can see when the undervolting is only undervolt the GPU core. The other component like VRM or VRAM is not undervolted. So if really bad if you put very low wattage on the GPU chip, the performance difference is very huge. When I test 70% to 80%, the performance impact is very huge. So my best suggestion is at 80% if you want to save the power consumption. Yeah, there is no other way to undervolt the VRAM or VRM or other component from this card. You can only undervolt the GPU core. I don't do any overclocking VRAM because yeah, it might be a risk to overclock the VRAM. You make me do it by yourself, but in this video I will not show you to overclock VRAM, and I not suggest you to overclock VRAM because the VRAM temperature is already high, so it's better to keep at the stock. Well, that's all from me. I hope this undervolting video helped you to reduce the power consumption of your RTX 3080 Ti. It's really good to undervolt your GPU because your GPU will consume less power than the stock, and also less power means less heat. If you like this video, please press like and subscribe. Thanks for watching, and I hope you like this video.